wrestling fans, Bob Coleman, David Crockett. Welcome to Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling, and we got an action-packed hour for you.
Right, David? Just hear those fans over there. They can't wait, because in the ring right now, and you'll see him in just a few moments, Ricky Steamboat's here.
He's a favorite of the fans.
That's
everywhere.
Right, he Rick really Steamboat. Is.
The Russian Bear is going to be here. Ivan Koloff also, David.
That's right. Then we're going to see Sergeant Slaughter and Jim Nelson. They're tagging together. So that's going to be interesting.
Boy, from New York City, Jimmy Valiant.
Yes, that's right. And then Ray Stevens is going to be around.
All right, Ray the Crippler. That's
yes,
right.
And the Crippler has something to tell us. That, what about? Now, you heard Ole Anderson talk about that.
I heard Ole and Roddy Piper talking, and they said, hey, nobody can trust Steamboat or Youngblood or nobody. Nobody can really trust Ray Stevens anymore.
Well, we have something to show you and tell you about that a little later on in the program. But first, Sergeant Slaughter is here.
All right, Sergeant Slaughter right here. Yes, sir.
That's
and Jim
right.
Nelson right there with you.
That's right. Nelson, I want you to stand attention, and I want you to listen to me, and I want all the maggots out there listening to me. Now, I hear a bunch of wrestlers around here say they want to try the Cobra Clutch for $1,000. Well, right here, my friend, is $1,000 in cash if you like to count it, and I'll have you hold on to it. And the first man that ever breaks that hold will get that money. You got that?
Right.
Don't you be putting that in your account either, Crockett. You put that in your safe. And I'm telling all the maggots out there, the Roberts, the Mulligans, the seniors and the juniors, the Steamboats, the Youngbloods, the Big Thorn in the sides, if you want to try the Cobra Clutch, you come out here and we'll do it right in the middle of the ring. Don't be coming around when I've been wore out or I've had a match. Come out here right now and we'll do it. Another thing I want to talk about is a U.S. title. I have kept this title now for 3 months and I plan to keep it for 3 years. And Private Nelson right here has also been winning all his matches. And I'd just like to say a few words to Private Nelson, if you don't mind.
All right.
Nelson, are you ready to go into combat?
Yes, sir.
I can't hear you, Nelson.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Nelson, now will you give me 20 push-ups?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's go. One, two, one, two. Now you see how Nelson respects and does anything I tell him to do. He'll do push-ups till I tell him to stop. You ready, Nelson? You ready to stop, Nelson?
Yes, sir.
Okay, get up on your feet, boy.
Yes, sir.
Stand at attention. Anybody that is watching now can see the respect that I have. And that's what I want these wrestlers around here, all these maggots around here, to have some respect because I am the U.S. champion. Do you have any questions for me or Private Nelson?
Not after that.
Well, then
no,
you're
sir.
Excused. You're
all
excused.
Right. Sergeant Dismissed. Slaughter, Dismissed. Jim Nelson, and we're going to see them together in a tag team match a little later in the program. Also, that challenge that went out to all the wrestlers, of course, from Sergeant Slaughter. Let's go to the ring now, the introduction for our first match. And our opponents for this match, one fall, 10-minute time limits. First, from Ohio at 245 pounds, here is Charlie Fulden. Charlie Fulden. His opponent across the ring from Hawaii, 235 pounds. Here is Rick Steamboat. Rick Steamboat, one fall, 10-minute time limit. We'll be back. We'll have the action right after this message. Rick Steamboat in against Charlie Fulden. And David, this should be an outstanding match as we've got two really tough competitors in there. Charlie Fulden, who is a rugged individual and a big one at about 245 pounds. Of course, he's in against Rick Steamboat. And as we mentioned earlier, Steamboat, one of the favorites of fans everywhere and an outstanding wrestler and competitor in the ring.
That's right. You see Charlie Fulden in there. Both men are very cautious at this point. All right, see a headlock.
Headlock hip toss right there by Steamboat. Fulden had him stacked up for just a moment. And fans, I know, I tell you, I was almost dumbfounded when Sergeant Slaughter was standing out at the beginning of the program and when he was talking and yelling. David, Slaughter can do that to you. He can just looking you in the
eye. He's very intimidating.
He can freeze you, you know. You don't want to move when he looks at you. And, of course, he challenged anyone and any wrestler that wanted to get into the ring that can get out of that Cobra Clutch $1,000. $1,000 from Sergeant Slaughter if they can break the Cobra Clutch.
That's correct. There you see. Steamboat now. Nice drop kick on Charlie Fulton. Steamboat takes him, headlock, takes him over, holds him down.
All right, now Fulden in that headlock down on the mat as he's trying to get free. David, another thing that I think all of the fans are going to really be interested in seeing, and that is, as we commented earlier, about Ole Anderson and Roddy Piper,
yes,
saying that Ray Stevens cannot be trusted. Watch out for Ray Stevens. Fans, stay with us, because as we mentioned earlier,
that's right,
we got something we want you to
the
see.
The person who needs to watch out is Ole Anderson. All right, with us right now is Sandy Scott, NWA representative. Sandy, I think you have something to tell us.
Well, yes, I was just hearing back there the sergeant talking about putting up $1,000 to anybody, a challenge to anybody that can get out
of his
hole.
Get out of that Cobra clutch. That's
well,
right, Sandy.
I believe he's going to have him standing in line for that because, you know, Christmas is right around the corner and that $1,000 would come in handy.
That's right.
$1,000 come in handy anytime.
Sure will.
Yes, for any professional Sandy, wrestler that wants to challenge him for that $1,000.
That's right. But now, Sandy, wait a minute. You know, you say they're going to be standing in line, but now let's face it. That is a very, very deadly, difficult hole to get out of. And the Slaughter, Sergeant Slaughter, he's a master at that hole, Sandy. There's no doubt about that. He's got to have a lot of confidence in it, or he wouldn't be putting up $1,000, right?
What I've seen of it, he's had Nelson in there to soften the man up, then he comes in and puts a hold on. Let's see what he does with a fresh man in there.
All right.
I'll buy that. Since you said it, well, it's going to be you that's going to have to stand up to him there. As I mentioned to David earlier, when he looks you in the eyes, that guy really intimidates you.
Oh, yes.
He is mean, rough, tough. Steamboat now with a headlock on Charlie Fulton as they're both down on the mat, putting the pressure on that headlock. And we're going to see Ray the Crippler Stevens also a little later on. You don't want to miss him. And we're going to see Slaughter and Nelson in a tag team match. And I tell you, look at that move by Steamboat coming
That's
out
right.
of the corner, David. I tell you something else, David. I want to see this Jimmy Valiant again. He's an exciting man to watch in the ring.
Handsome Jimmy. Right now, Steamboat's been sticking with that the headlock just to wear Charlie down. All right, Charlie backs him into the ropes, though. Needs to watch himself. Steamboat needs to watch it.
Well, referee Sonny Fargo says break it, but let's see what's going to happen. We're going to get a break. Hey, most unusual.
Too good to be true.
Fulton backed away, and we get a good, clean break. Sandy Scott is still right here with us. Sandy, I want to ask you, and we had talked about it for several weeks now, and you being the representative from the NWA and really sort of on a talent search for Mid-Atlantic Wrestling, you've been bringing in and are going to continue to bring in a number of outstanding stars to Mid-Atlantic Wrestling, right?
That's true. We're on the lookout for all top professional wrestlers. And we have contacts over in Europe, Japan, Australia, and they're going to send us names of these fellas. We're going to look at them, and if they're top people, we're going to bring them in. But, you know, Ole Anderson and Piper mentioned to me not too long ago, they're wondering when Steven says something if his word can be trusted.
Yeah, right. They say you can't trust it.
Well, I think you can, and I think we got a piece of film to show that a little later on.
That's right.
We have. You're right, Sandy. Fans, you don't want to miss that. Here is Fulton, who's got Steamboat down on the mat, and I can't tell from this position whether it's a choke or not, but he is really putting the
pressure
on it.
Referee Sonny Fargo has checked it, and he says it's not a choke.
I think Steamboat is trying to holler that it is, though, David, and I can't blame him. He wants out from under that as Fulton. Those big, tremendous arms of Charlie Fulton and all of that power in those shoulders and arms as he's got him tightly in that headlock. Steamboat trying to get that wrist now.
Yes. Trying to get it up.
Just trying to get in a position to get enough leverage to get the strength behind it to come up with a wrist. On one knee now.
He just about got it. Almost.
Well, he went with a chop, and that was a good move right there.
Nice tackle.
Off of the ropes again. Oh, and he missed. David, he went high in the air. He was going to splatter Fulton.
That's right.
Instead, ooh, the count of two on Steamboat. Instead, it was Steamboat who splattered himself all over that mat.
And Fulton right back to applying the pressure to the neck and chin. Steamboat,
I tell you,
he's winded.
Charlie
knocked
Fulton
the wind
right
out of
there,
him.
He was really thinking and he was really on his toes.
Yes.
Good action there from Charlie Fulton and good wrestling. And Charlie Fulton has done a tremendous job here against Rick Steamboat. He is extending Steamboat and then some.
Yes.
Steamboat stays on the rope.
Fulton is going in. Going in for the kill now.
He may be going for the kill right now. as he keeps driving with that right hand.
The fans sense this. Steamboat has to make his move. He's trying.
Hard chop to the top of the head. Spence pulled it around. Another chop. Drops him to a knee.
Chop to the back of the neck. Into the chest. Now Fulton's day. Takes the hand, rams it into the turnbuckle.
I think Rick Steamboat sensed that it could all be over for him right there. Yes. And that he had to come back and he had to do it right then. And he's now making a tremendous showing here against Fulton.
Steamboat now working on that arm and shoulder. Takes Fulton now, whips him into the ropes. Grabs the arm. Surfboard.
High into the air with a surfboard. Fulton says yes very quickly. Steamboat right. Still holding him up in the air.
That shows exactly why. He started working on that arm, shoulder, and that was for the surfboard. There we see it. AC Steamboat working on that arm, the shoulder.
He slammed him into that corner on that turnbuckle hard on that arm, went back in again off of the ropes. Hooked that arm as he came off of the ropes, and right here, as he got him up for the surfboard, it was all over. There you have the winner, Rick Steamboat. We'll be back. We'll have more action right after we take time out for this match. Fans, the NWA TV champion, Ivan Koloff, the Russian Bear, in right now against Jim Gray.
All right, remember that this championship is at stake for the first 15 minutes of the match. You have to win by a pinfall or a submission.
Any time that the TV champion is wrestling, yes. That belt, the first 15 minutes of any match, David, that belt is
that's correct.
Is that right? All right, and being the champion, of course, Koloff. Koloff takes a lot of pride in that belt, and he's gonna defend it and do almost anything to keep it.
That's right.
It means an awful lot to him. As do all the championship belts, yes. David, to all these wrestlers. After all, it shows you that, and shows everybody that
there's
you're really
something.
The top in your profession.
Right.
You're above the crowd. You're something extra. You're something a little bit better.
You're a somebody.
All right, Koloff rolls Gray up. Oh, count of one. Quickly, he kicked out of it.
But stays with him. Koloff stays. Gray tried to come out of it. All right, Gray backs him into the rope. Backs Koloff into the ropes now. Referee calls for the break. See what happens. Koloff.
Koloff's not going to break on those ropes. That's right. Got Gray up, just lifted him right up by the hair, that big right hand, then right into the face. Backflip coming off.
Look at that.
Off.
Koloff holds on, though. Koloff now. Just wearing his opponent down.
With that chin lock. Pressure now on that as Gray is down on one knee. Or he's on both knees at the moment trying to get up.
He's trying now. Trying to break loose. But Koloff has this tremendous grip on him. He's just about out now. Just about. Knee
and
to the back.
Koloff with that knee. Koloff knew, and right at the moment when Gray thought he was going to get out and be free.
You know what Koloff is going to try. He's going to try to wear him down, work on the back of the neck. Get on that top rope and drive him straight through that mat.
Get that knee, that's right. Get that knee in the back of the head and the back of the neck and drive him to the mat. Favorite move of Ivan Koloff. And David, in all of the times that we've seen Koloff use that, we have never seen anybody able to get up from
him. That's right. See, he's going to the back. He's staying with the back now.
By the hair, through the ropes. On the apron and down on the floor now comes Jim Gray. Koloff just had him by the hair and just drove him and slung him right through the ropes. He's a vicious man.
Yes, he is. Watch this. Right across the chest. Koloff again comes right back.
He's not going to let him get back in the ring.
Yes, he is. He's going to help him.
As he does, flips him right over that top rope.
Takes him now. Puts him across into the ropes. Knee into the chest. Foot, excuse me.
Ivan Koloff, who loves
watch
to
this.
Maul his opponent, right up all of his weight right down on the stomach.
Koloff is what, 250, 260, somewhere
that's
around?
That's right. And again, a big boot right into the midsection.
The knee now.
I think Ivan Koloff at the moment is taking a great deal of pleasure in just mauling and working over Jim Gray. High for the slam.
And that's what he's doing.
He doesn't want to pin him at the moment. He wants to enjoy this.
He's working the man over.
Yes! Get up there and break his neck!
The Russian Bear, the NWA TV champion, Ivan Koloff. You're seeing him right now at his wicked best.
Yes.
Well, I tell you, we've got plenty of tough, rough characters in Mid-Atlantic Wrestling, David. Ooh, he
Great
kicked
kick out.
You got to add Sergeant Slaughter into that category. You got to add Roddy Piper, and of course you can't forget Ole Anderson.
Oh yes,
one half of the Minnesota Wrecking Crew right there. John Studd. The list can go on and on and on. Koloff. Well, he's trying to pin right now, David, and he must be getting a little exasperated at the fact that he's not able to hold Gray and hold both shoulders to the mat. Up now and again with that knee right down across the chest. Hard right hand, and he has already landed a blow or two on Gray's nose because he has got a bloody nose at this point in the match.
You learn by your mistakes, Mr. Gray. Punish your opponent, Koloff.
David, that's a tough way to learn.
It sure is.
When you get in against a man like Ivan Koloff, you're fortunate if you can just escape with your life.
I thought Koloff was going to go up on the... No.
Watch this. Well, he's going to change it. He's going to come off of the rope high in the air with that knee drop right down across the midsection. Off of the top rope with a knee. Grabs that leg, hooks it in, puts Gray's shoulders to the mat.
Mr. Gray tried.
No way. He put up a gallant fight. A tremendous effort on the part of Gray. He was really just outgunned by the NWA TV champ, Ivan Koloff. In slow motion here is Koloff now off that top rope, high into the air, with that knee and all that weight right across the midsection. One, two, three, it's all over. With a winner, Ivan Koloff.
Wrestling fans, there's a great card of live action returning to the Civic Center in Roanoke, Virginia, Saturday, February the 20th. And on that card, you'll see Austin Idol, Ninja, the Japanese Assassin, plus Rowdy Roddy Piper, Ivan Koloff, the Russian Bear, Porkchop Cash, Jay Youngblood, Ray Crippler Stevens, and handsome Jimmy Boogie Woogie Valiant. Then coming to Marion, Virginia High School Gym, Tuesday, February the 16th, you want to be there to see Lord Alfred Hayes. Plus, in tag team action, you'll see Ray Crippler Stevens and Johnny Weaver, the Dean of Wrestling, in the squared circle against the Ninja and Gene Anderson.
And that's right, I'm going to be climbing in the ring. I'm going to put my tights on, and I'm going to team up with Ninja against that town in Virginia, Marion. And Ray Stevens and Johnny Weaver. Stevens, we go back a long ways, and Weaver goes back even further with us. But Ninja and I are going to show the people right there in Marion, Virginia, that we know something about wrestling. Weaver goes back a long time, but Stevens, you took our belts. Now we're going to get a piece of your body in Marion on Tuesday.
At the Marion, Virginia High School Gym, fans, Tuesday, February the 16th, a super card that also includes Ricky Steamboat in the squared circle against Roddy Piper.
I scare Flair. Wahoo McDaniels crumbles at the mere mention of my name. People run and flee when I walk down the street, Mr. Ricky Steamboat. Everybody that I've ever fought my whole life fears Roddy Piper. Except you. What's wrong with you, huh? So your parents build you a swing facing a wall when you were a kid? Is that what the problem is, huh? Don't you know that when you fight me, you're risking your entire career? And you pick a spot like Marion, because you think if you get me away all by myself, away from my friends, you're going to be able to do some kind of damage. Well, let me tell you something, Mr. Ricky Steamboat. I didn't get where I am by being stupid. Nuts, yes. I didn't get where I am by being stupid, Mr. Ricky Steamboat. I'm not going to get to Marion on my own. I'm going to have plenty of friends. Oh, yes, I know you're crying and weeping because I got the title. You're crying and saying, please give me a title shot. If I win in Marion, would you give me a title shot? And they say yes. Well, let me tell you something, Ricky Steamboat. You win some, and you lose some.
As a little earlier in the program, we were saying that Ole Anderson and Roddy Piper are saying that Ray Stevens cannot be trusted. He cannot be trusted by Steamboat, by Youngblood, by anyone. Nobody can trust Ray Stevens.
Well, I beg to differ with Mr. Anderson because Mr. Stevens has helped a few people, and I think he can be trusted. We have a tape we'd like to show you right now. Ray Stevens helping out Ricky Steamboat, and you'll see why Ole Anderson and Roddy Piper are talking.
It's Mike Prater, a newcomer here, and Sandy Scott still with me at ringside. Sandy?
I'm going to go back, and I want to check that fella's arm, and also I want to talk to that manager of Ninja.
Jimmy Holiday? Yes. Find out about that green stuff, that fog? Okay, good. Sandy, thank you. And we'll get a report to you on Danny Jones as to the condition of his arm and how severe it may be. Right now, though, we've got a good match in the ring as we see a big newcomer, Mike Prater, up against Rick Steamboat. Steamboat ducks under the big right hand. As now both wrestlers kind of stalk each other and size each other up. Come to grips, side headlock, reverses. Goes right to the arm, quick takedown. Steamboat now has the arm up, hammerlock, and he's got his arm locked in tight on it. Knee drop. And coming out here to ringside now, Rowdy Piper. And I hope that he's just here to watch and not interfere. What's he doing? Huh? Referee Sonny Fargo questioning why he's out here. Now you see Steamboat looking over at the ringside, keeping his eye on Piper.
You have to give me a chance to push you in the corner.
A few words there between Steamboat and Piper. Steamboat still working on the arm of Prater. Prater, I believe, from Texas. And if his size is any indication that he is, of course, everything comes large and from Texas.
Another one of your masked men? Huh? What do I have to prove to you? Huh? What do I have to prove? Oh!
Steamboat with the advantage, top wrist lock on Prater. Piper moves a little closer to the ring. He's out of camera angle right now for you fans, but believe me, he's here at ringside and watching the match very intensely. Test of strength now between Prater and Steamboat. Both have a top wrist lock. Steamboat, nice sweep, and comes over with a leg takedown and goes right back to the arm. Steamboat still working on Prater's arm. Prater draws back, but each time he does, Steamboat applies a little more pressure. Nice takedown. Roddy Piper still here at ringside. Prater rammed into the turnbuckle, shoulder first. Steamboat, since the opening bell, has had the advantage over Prater. Piper says he could. Steamboat couldn't do that to him. There you see Piper at ringside. Double thrust on Mike Prater. Steamboat goes outside the ring, climbs the turnbuckles, off the top turnbuckle. Prater turns and walks right into a big chop. Lateral press. Piper up on the ring. He goes to work on Steamboat, but Steamboat is the winner. Steamboat is the winner of the match over Mike Prater. In comes Ole Anderson from ringside.
Touchdown, referee Sonny Fargo. Now, Steamboat being double-teamed in the ring by Piper and Ole Anderson. Ray Stevens is coming in. Richard breaking up. He goes right to work on Ole. He's slinging it out. Ole hits the mat. Piper exits the ring. Ole exits the ring. And all that's left is Rick Steamboat and Ray Stevens.
As they come back, Ole Anderson charged back into that ring. Knocked referee Sonny Fargo down. And help Piper jump on Ricky Steamboat. And we'll see Ray Stevens come back in and in just a minute, and you'll see why Ray Stevens can be trusted.
That's right, David. Regardless of what Ole Anderson and Roddy Piper are saying and the word that they're putting out, and I think this is something I wanted everybody to believe, all of the wrestlers to believe at least, is the fact that Stevens could not be trusted. And as you say, we're going to see it again right here.
There you see Stevens coming into the ring to help Ricky Steamboat against Roddy Piper and Ole Anderson. And he's really working on Mr. Anderson.
He's going after Ole, hasn't he? All right, regardless now of what Piper and Ole are saying, that film and what you just saw, fans, is proof positive, I think.
Yes.
David, I think you'll agree that Ray Stevens certainly can be trusted.
That's right, he can. And ladies and gentlemen, we have him in the ring right now. Ray Stevens.
Ray the Crippler Stevens in one corner, and across the ring, his opponent, Mike Prater, referee Sonny Fargo. Now says ring the bell and let's go with the action. And Prater. Boy, Prater. The bell sounded. Stevens didn't even have his jacket off, and Prater came charging.
That's right. He wants every advantage he can get. Hey, look at Stevens. Hard right.
With his
another hard right. Yes. Picks him up.
Big man up. And Prater is a big one. Slammed hard down to the mat now by Stevens.
All right, Stevens grabs him. Pile driver. Yes, fire. Yes. Pile driver. Yeah. He's about 2 inches shorter. Goes for that pin.
And that's a big man. About 255 or 60 pounds. Pile drive by Ray Stevens. And Stevens, you don't make that man mad.
No. They don't call him the Crippler for nothing.
That's right. Ray the Crippler Stevens with that pile driver. Prater not even letting him get his win before he attacked him.
Look at him pick him up.
David, all the time that match was going on, we never had a chance to get it out of the ring. Right in the corner was that world, and you see it right in the background.
World championship belt.
That world championship tag team belt that Ray Stevens brought into the studio with him. And, of course, that belongs to Ole Anderson. And it was right there in that corner.
Ray Stevens will differ you. Talk to you about that.
All right, fans, there you see it, our winner, Ray Stevens. And we'll be back. We'll have more action right after this match. Fans, here he is right here ringside, and he just made quick work of Mike Prater in the ring. But Ray Stevens and Ray Ole Anderson, Roddy Piper, they've been telling everybody, they've been putting the word out, Ray Stevens can't be trusted. Nobody can trust him. But I think that film that all the fans saw a little earlier proved otherwise.
Well, let me just clarify a few things right here and right now. It isn't a matter of being trusted or not. Now, I know there's a lot of people who don't like me, a lot of wrestlers that don't like me for the way that I wrestle. And I don't deny that I'll kick somebody when they're down simply because it's easier than when they're standing up. And I enjoy hurting people, and that's why I've been a winner all of my career of wrestling. But I'm going to tell you something else. All my life, and you can ask any wrestler in the profession, when I tell you I'm going to do something, you can take it to the bank because my word is my bond. And you know what? When I tell somebody that I'm going to go out and break somebody's leg, I'll go break their leg. Or if I tell them I'm going to beat somebody up, I beat them up. Or if I tell somebody I'm going to be their tag partner, I will be there. And I don't care if it's Ricky Steamboat, or if it's Jay Youngblood, or if it's Greg Valentine, or Sergeant Slaughter, I will be there. But Ole Anderson, you have sacrificed so many people in professional wrestling just to win. You've sacrificed your own brother, not only once, but twice. And I want you to look at his brother now. He's like this, stands around going like this. Ole Anderson, you've done that to your own brother to win. Well, you're not doing it to Ray Stevens or nobody else is. Ole Anderson, I got your gold right here, brother. And if you want it, you're going to have to go through me to get it. And you have never wrestled anybody as mean as me, because I don't care about the rules. I'll throw them out the window, and you know it. So come and get your gold if you're man enough.
Pounds, a big, rough, tough customer, but
hey,
I tell you, Ballard is feeling good.
Yes, the fans love him.
He's rocking and rolling tonight.
Yes, he is. If we catch a quick
good arm
if
drag.
You look at the back of his truck, it says,
no.
I'm not going to say it.
All right, Miller right out of the ring, and Valiant in the center of the ring now, clapping and stomping around. Fans, don't want to forget that our next match, you're going to see Sergeant Slaughter and Jim Nelson team together. I tell you, as Sandy Scott said, you're going to see them lined up, I think, to win that $1,000.
That is right.
That Slaughter challenged any wrestler, any professional wrestler, if they could get out of his Cobra clutch, $1,000 to the wrestler that can do that.
And let's talk about Ray Stevens.
David, we just talked to Stevens a little bit earlier, and I tell you, you're talking about mad. That guy, he's furious.
Oh, yes.
Irate is not the word for Ray Stevens.
I think Ole Anderson, Gene Anderson, Roddy Piper, guys, you've been watching. You know what he can do. Almost.
Yeah, Valiant slam. Miller back down to the mat, trying to go for the pin. Got the count of two on him. Well, and I tell you something that I noticed, and I was very happy to notice it too, was that Ray Stevens still has a championship belt. He's going to care. He says Ole's not going to get it away from him.
Well, that's what Ole's upset about.
Oh, yeah. No way. He's going to have to go through Ray Stevens to get it. Here's Valiant right into the corner now after Miller. Whips him across the ring and the ropes, and that elbow got him right in the mouth and the chin.
Yes, it did. Elbow across the chest. Goes
this could
to the
be
pin.
It
yes.
Right here. One, two, three. Well, Valiant.
Wrestling fans, coming to Roanoke, Virginia Civic Center. It's a great card of live NWA wrestling action, Saturday, February the 20th. This card includes Austin Idol, Ninja, Roddy Piper, Ivan Koloff, Porkchop Cash, Jay Youngblood, Ray Crippler Stevens, and handsome Jimmy Valiant. Then coming to Marion, Virginia, to the high school gym in Marion, it's a super card scheduled for Tuesday, February the 16th. You'll see Lord Alfred Hayes. Plus, in tag team action, Ray Crippler Stevens teams up with Johnny Weaver, the Dean of Wrestling, to take on Gene Anderson and his Ninja.
That's right. Gene Anderson now is going to put his tights on. He is managing again. He's managing the Ninja. He's got the Japanese assassin, a man of mystery, comes up with a lot of unusual things and a lot of unusual offensive weapons. To beat this team, figured you're going to have a guy on your side that knows everything about breaking rules, and he will break the rules, Ray Stevens. However, it goes a little farther than that, because at one time, Ole Anderson, when they were world tag team champions, sacrificed his brother to win a match to keep the belts. Then he tried to do it with Ray Stevens, and that didn't set too well with Stevens. Gene, you may be willing to sacrifice yourself to win the match, but not at the expense of Ray Stevens. It's going to be a knockdown, drag-out battle. You better have your Ninja have something up his sleeve, because we're going to break rules just to win this match.
Okay, an exciting match right there in the Marion, Virginia High School gym. Ninja Gene Anderson against Ray Stevens and the Dean of Wrestling, Johnny Weaver. Let's bring in Ricky Steamboat. Rick, you've got a match in the squared circle against Roddy Piper.
That's correct, Ken. You know, ever since Roddy Piper's come into this area, I've got to say I've never seen any one person in all my life talk about himself as the way Roddy Piper does. I mean, this guy doesn't even get up here and talk about the weather. He doesn't get up here and talk about girls. He doesn't get up here and talk about partying. He doesn't get up here and talk about nothing but himself. He says that when he talks, though, everybody listens. Like when R.P. talks, everybody listens. And he can't help it because he gets up and he tells that he just lays down. I'm just a freak of nature. I can't help it. Well, time and time again, Piper, you know that I've gotten on TV and I've issued challenges out to you to wrestle you for that belt. And you say, why did I pick Marion? Well, it doesn't matter where I have to go to wrestle you. I'll go anywhere. But the point that I want to get across, that it doesn't matter where we have to go or what we're going to eventually do, I just want to get a piece of you.
Ring the bell, I guess. I got...
Referee Sonny Fargo with a signal to bell. That's Slaughter, Sergeant Slaughter, Jim Nelson.
Hey, look at this. Sergeant Slaughter really has confidence in him, man. Jim Nelson.
He just went out and left Nelson right here by himself. Let's get the microphone. You left Nelson up there in the ring by himself.
Nelson can handle both these guys by himself, I think. But I'm out here to tell all the maggots out there and all the wrestlers that I still have that $1,000 up for that challenge. And Mr. Crockett has the money. And if I get a chance to put it on today, I'm going to do it because I have a couple of challengers. And when this match is over, I just might have a challenge.
Oh, boy. Hey, that
There's
I like.
Any wrestlers out there that think they had enough guts to come out here and
All right, turn around then.
All right,
turn around.
Here's
a young man.
Here is Jay Youngblood.
You're not wrestling. I want the $1,000 after this match is over. We have time.
All right, what do you say to that, Sergeant?
We got time. There's a couple other guys that want a chance.
I already got out of it with Jay Nelson.
Hey, Slaughter, he just walked off. Youngblood. Jay, he just walked away from you. Got up into the ring, went over to his corner.
This man is using everything that he can, Bob, for an excuse, and I'm not going to stand for it. I'm going to stay here until this is all over.
All right, Jay Youngblood says he's going to wait on him.
All right.
And we'll see what happens after the match. Sergeant Slaughter right now just looking around over there in that corner just like nothing's going on, while his partner and his protege, Jim Nelson, is having a handful right out there of Tony Anthony. There's Slaughter now with that elbow. The big, rough, tough Marine up to the elbow. U.S. heavyweight champ. And he says nobody can get out of that. Nobody can get out of that Cobra clutch.
But he puts it on. That's what he says.
All right, Anthony got to his feet. And again, Slaughter just swept his legs right out from under him, took him back down on the mat. The big man can really wrestle, but he is just as mean as they come. Lambs Anthony to the mat by a hair. Anthony's partner, Larry Hamilton, still outside right now. And it wouldn't hurt Anthony to get over to get a tag.
No, it wouldn't. Watch this. That knocks all the wind out of you. Goes for that pin. No, he's not ready to pin him yet.
All right, it's Slaughter who makes the tag, and here's Nelson. Fans, David and I are going to leave it to you, and you can make up your own mind. I'm convinced that Ray Stevens can be trusted, and I think, David, you are too.
Yes.
And I think that film and that match that we showed earlier prove that, regardless of what Ole Anderson and Roddy Piper are saying.
Let him prove himself.
Absolutely.
Ray wants to, so let him do it. I said, you fans be the judge.
Good takedown by Anthony. Nelson now. Here's the tag. Hamilton comes charging in, and Nelson's right after him.
Yes.
David, you got to admit one thing. Since Jim Nelson has been under the leadership of Sergeant Slaughter, I think he's a changed individual.
Yes, very
he's
aggressive.
He's much rougher in that ring. He's very aggressive. I think he's really been pumping iron and lifting weights and working out.
Yes.
He's put on a lot of upper body weight. He's bigger, he's rougher, he's tougher, he's meaner. And I think Slaughter's going to make him a man really to be reckoned with.
I have to agree with you.
A much, much improved wrestler is Jim Nelson. Slaughter now with that wrist. Well, he got the feet right up into the chest, but it only backed that big man up a couple of feet. You got to give him a mule kick to get him up much. I'll tell you, as big as
nice arm drag. Take a man's arm off.
Oh, boy, did he forever slam Slaughter to the mat. Drop kick, and he fell right on top of Hamilton. Slaughter now with an uppercut, a forearm, back into the corner for the tag. Here is Tony Anthony now.
Anthony comes in, ties up with Slaughter.
Fans, Jay Youngblood is true to his word.
He's
David,
still here.
Youngblood is standing right here. Youngblood, you said you were good. Jay, you said you were going to wait on Slaughter, and here you are.
Hey, I got out of Jim Nelson, his private. He put it on me, and I got out, and I proved to everybody else. And Slaughter didn't want to do it. And now, Slaughter is going to have to do it, or I might have to just slap him.
Wow.
I'm going to have to do something to insult him or do something.
Those are tough words. But he is true to his word, standing right here waiting on this match to end. He wants a shot at that $1,000 that Sergeant Slaughter says he'll give anybody that can get out of that Cobra Clutch. And Jay Youngblood evidently feels very strongly that he can get out of it.
Yes, he does. Ooh, knee into the midsection. Sergeant Slaughter. Slaughter now.
Slaughter is very methodical the way he moves around the ring and the way he attacks his opponent. Going to make a tag again, and we're going to have a switch. You can tell that he's worked a lot with Nelson and that they've worked a lot together. They're beginning to think alike, and they move more as one individual in the ring. Hamilton. Lefts and rights is backing. Nelson into the ropes, who just turns him around, and as he has him draped across that rope, lands that big right.
Hard slam to the mat. Nelson comes across.
Elbow smash and missed it. Quick diving tag.
He needs to stay with that arm.
And he missed that drop kick.
He should have gone right with that arm.
He went up into the air for the drop kick. Nelson grabbed the ropes, and he's in trouble now. Bad trouble. Slammed again into the knee. And he's got to be plenty groggy as Nelson's going to hold him for Slaughter. Jay, you're still here. You may get your chance.
I'm not leaving, Bob. I'm not leaving. I just want the time. If there's time left in this, I want that opportunity. He's talking big and
hey,
bad.
Hey, here it is. Look up there. You see that, don't you, Jay? David, there it is.
That's right.
That Cobra Clutch. Tony Anthony's not going to get out of it. Jay, Tony Anthony's not going to be able to get out of it. That's for sure.
Hey, all I'm doing, he worked Anthony down, but all I'm doing is asking him to put it on me. No, I'm not doubting his ability at all. All I am doing is telling him just to put the hole on, because I believe I can get it out of it. I feel very, very strong.
Sergeant Slaughter with that Cobra Clutch on Tony Anthony.
There you see it. Sergeant Slaughter has it locked in. Anthony trying to fight it any way he can. But he just cannot get out. Your winner, Sergeant Slaughter and Jim Nelson.
Fans still true to his word right here.
Okay, Slaughter.
Here he is, okay, Sergeant Slaughter. Here's Jay Youngblood.
Okay. Why don't you get your tail in that ring and put it on?
Why do you have to come here after I've wrestled?
What
I'm a little bit tired
about now. Hey, you put the thing on me after he jumped me from the back. I got out of it.
What time are his? Who's going to do the talking?
Well, now, wait a minute.
I got out of
you
it.
You challenged anyone. With
I challenged everyone. He's already had his chance. There's guys like Davis, Miller, Larson that want to try it. And I think if Miller was here, or how about Davis? Get Davis to come out here, and I'll put it on him. You've had your chance, Youngblood.
You got him in.
You've had your chance.
It's not that I've had my chance. I got out of it with Nelson. And the only way you did put it on me is because we bashed heads. Look at the size of that head. Who wouldn't bash something like that? Now you get your tail in that ring, boy, now.
He's had his chance, Bob. I'm going to give a chance to somebody worthy of it, like Davis or Larson or someone like that, because they deserve a chance at it. He's had his chance, and I don't think he should have another chance. Crockett, you still have that $1,000 they gave you at the top of the show. So that's my money, and I should be able to pick my opponent. I'm tired now. I don't have to do this thing.
That's not what you said, though. At the beginning of the program, you came out with $1,000, and you said, I challenge him.
Excuse me. Listen, Scott,
just a minute. Our NWA representative right here.
You put an open challenge up.
That's right.
To anybody.
Davis is next.
Get in the ring. You're going to go against this man.
What are you talking about? What do I have to do with him? He's had his chance. He had his chance. What do I have to do to him again?
Open challenge up. Get in the ring.
I have to get in the ring?
Right.
What if I don't get in the ring?
Well, then there's ways that we can just strip you of everything.
What are you doing?
All right, Sandy.
Put an open challenge up to anybody. Well, this man here, young brother, challenge.
Come on.
He's going to have to answer it.
All right, Sandy. Hey, I'm glad you were around, Sandy, because there's no doubt he was going to back out of that. Sergeant Slaughter is giving some advice to his protege, Jim Nelson, out here. He was hollering some words of advice to him. Here comes Ole Anderson into the studio. And, hey, wait a minute, Sandy. He was just about to put that on and, oh, he's wanting him to sit down. All right, Jay.
Well, Scott, you're a pretty tough son of a gun. I remember when you were wrestling. I wish you were still wrestling. Maybe we could teach you a few lessons. You got this big authority now. Look at this. You're going to be sorry that you put Youngblood in there, because when that hole goes on, Mr. Youngblood, that's going to be all she wrote. He ain't going to get no $1,000.
You have problems of your own. I take care of them right now.
All right, wait, whoa, he was just about, and again, I think it was Sergeant Slaughter who broke and backed away.
Well, he's not so confident right now. He's out here yapping away, and now he looks like he's not so confident.
And now Ole Anderson is saying there's no time to come out.
Whoa, how much time is left here? How much time is left?
We don't have it.
3 seconds, and we don't have the time.
No time. You just piddled away the time.
There's no time left. Well, maybe next week you'll have enough time at the top of the show, and I'll give you one another chance at the top of the show next week. How would that be?
Yes, we'll see you next week. And until then.